understanding, it will add complexity to the existing vulnerable system, and water scarcity is definitely one of it. Reasons where agriculture is a marginal enterprise, for example, largely compounded by the factors such as rural poverty, water scarcity, and soil conditions, poor soil conditions. Even the slightest increase in climate change might have a significant role, adverse role. For example, the increase in number of people at risk of hunger. So in that end, I would say water scarcity is going to be compounded by climate change, and climate change can then compromise the resilience of the system. If you may, I might want to give an overview of what the Paris Agreement means, which might then connect with my response in terms of your question. So the Paris Agreement is, we consider this as a very important agreement, and it's the first time it brings all nations together in a very for a global cause to combat climate change, as well as to adapt to adverse effects of climate change in an innovative manner, and also most importantly by providing scaled up support to developing countries in doing so. So in that end, Paris Agreement sort of charts a very new course for a global climate discourse. And as you know, the Paris Agreement, the main objective of the Paris Agreement is to undertake this innovative actions, ambitious actions to combat climate change, primarily to limit the greenhouse gas emission reduction compared to the pre-industrial level, well below 2 degrees Celsius this century, and also while pursuing effects to limit temperature reduction further 1.5 degrees Celsius. So in order to achieve this ambitious goal, Paris Agreement also has put in place the mobilization and provision of financial resources, technological framework, capacity building, and in adaptation, for example, it's also an agreement on the goal of adaptation goal, global goal and adaptation. And it aims to significantly strengthen national adaptation initiatives, including through international cooperation. So here, I would say the global framework that has been initiated by FAO is a very good platform, an innovative platform, I would say, which mobilizes this partnership building by bringing together non-party stakeholders, which is, again, very clear invitation by the Paris Agreement.